Hi, I'm Niall Taylor, and I'm a fifth-generation shellfish farmer.
I'm Erin Ewald, and I manage the sustainability certification and environmental compliance at Taylor Shellfish. When I started at Taylor, we were using hand-drawn maps, and I knew there had to be a better way. So Niall and I are modernizing our company through GIS.
In our oyster bars, our customers are becoming interested in how and where their food is grown. Our goal is to educate them about our products and what makes them unique and special. Using GIS and easy-to-use field apps, we're changing not only how we do business, but how we tell our story. In fact, our Oyster Bar staff can use this story map on an iPad to do just that. For over 120 years, my family has farmed shellfish in the Puget Sound. We have environmentalism in our roots. Today, we're the only U.S. company to achieve the Aquaculture Stewardship Council, or ASC, certification, designating our shellfish are farmed responsibly. Our farm managers, thank you. Our farm managers and staff work day and night in all weather conditions to bring the best product to our customers. It's important for us to thank them for their hard work and dedication when telling this story. Each of our growing regions and farming techniques creates a unique flavor profile. This encourages both brand and geographic loyalty. In Samish Bay, the tide can recede over a mile to expose large sandy tidal flats, rich with nutrients. We grow oysters, clams, and gooey duck here. The Pacific and Shigoku oysters are the same species, but the Shigoku are tide tumbled and truly our premium oyster. And our Manila clams from Samish are some of our largest. But now let's talk about the fourth product. While all you geo-geeks at this geo-conference may have thought this is a geo-duck, it's pronounced gooey duck. We brought a live one with us. You want to see it? The gooey duck is a Pacific Northwest native and the world's largest burrowing clam. In the wild, they can live for more than 100 years and weigh more than 12 pounds. This may be the only time a gooey duck is the co-presenter on the user conference stage. He's a little shy, so we'll put him away for now. So how does GIS fit into our tide-to-table mission? We've been using GIS at Taylor Shellfish for less than a year, but we've taken advantage of ArcGIS Online and the mobile field apps to support the management of our products.
Our company is growing in both size and geographic reach, and these mobile apps are leading the way in our digital transformation. We have over 30 farms spread throughout the Pacific Northwest, with the highest concentration in the southern part of Puget Sound. Using Explore on our mobile devices, we're now able to take our real-time business, operations, and environmental data onto the farms with us. This ability to take a wealth of GIS data into the field, like our farms shown in blue, or priority habitats and substrate types, helps us understand the environment we're working in. As we combine this new understanding with generations of experience in a suitability analysis, we use this data to identify optimal growing areas for our different shellfish species. For example, we know that gooey duck grow best in deep sand, usually located near feeder bluffs, shown in blue and purple. After the analysis, shown in green, we've confirmed that this gooey duck farm here is well placed. Our farm manager can use Explore to see areas that are underutilized, or maybe confirm that conditions have changed. He can mark up the area using the new redlining function and make real-time suggestions on where the farm can expand. With many of our farms in rural areas, we lose cell coverage, not just microphone coverage.
Explore allows us the ability to go offline and still access our data and attachments. When enforcement officers from Fish and Wildlife come by and ask for our permit, we can provide the information no matter where we are. Meeting multiple levels of regulation requires significant documentation. To comply with permits and sustainable certification, we collect information about environmental conditions, such as the amount of shoreline debris we find and remove from our beaches. You got that? All right. Using Survey 123 on our phones allows us to demonstrate this responsibility for our farm gear and our commitment to environmental quality. We want to make field data collection a habit for our staff, and Survey 123 allows us to quickly configure and deploy tools for the field. The first survey I created was the herring spawn survey. Herring are a critical food source for Washington State's endangered salmon. And we survey the beach to ensure that our actions don't disturb their spawning sites. Crews liked the survey because it was easy to use and short. We're proud of our ASC certification. To achieve it, we had to demonstrate that we met their rigorous standards for both farms and processing. Survey 123 helped us collect this information and put a process in place to maintain the certification. I modified a Survey 123 restaurant sample to reflect the ASC requirements, and this saved me hours of work. The forage fish spawning habitat survey is a community sample published on ArcGIS online by the Washington State Department of Fish and Wildlife. It contains the steps needed to collect and share the required data with their biologist. We have a uniquely diverse workforce, many of whom are first and second generation Americans who have been with the company for years. English is not the only language they speak, so we created a multi-language survey available in Spanish and Khmer, the Cambodian language, for our farm debris monitoring. This encourages the habit to collect the information because it's accessible and easy to use for everyone. From regulatory requirements to Thailand trash, we have an app for that. By using and sharing these apps, we encourage all of our employees to contribute to sustainable aquaculture and a clean environment.
The Collector app is at the heart of our digital transformation. Our farmers collect operational farm data to update the related tables of their farm beds. We use the data they capture to evaluate the current status of our farms and as a foundation for institutional knowledge. We're taking information that was once only in our farmers' heads and putting it into a shareable system. In the early stages of our GIS implementation, Brian, one of our farm directors, was in a serious car accident. When his external injuries healed and he returned to work, he became frustrated as he realized the accident had impacted his ability to quickly recall the fine details of his farms. Recognizing his struggle, we loaded up his information and asked him to test it for us. Thanks to Collector, Brian is able to continue confidently in his role and is now our strongest advocate for mobile apps.
Oakland Bay produces some of the world's best oysters and clams. While an important growing area for us for nearly 50 years, the local Squaxin tribe has been harvesting shellfish there for centuries. When water quality began to decline due to land use problems, we started to work with our tribal colleagues and put into place a coordinated effort to improve the health of our watershed. We're starting to use workforce to manage the water quality sample assignments in Oakland Bay. We invited Erica, our colleague at the Squaxin tribe, to our workforce project to collaborate on these efforts. When we have a 1-inch rainfall event that triggers the sampling, I can go in and select the sample points and create the assignment. If these were freshwater samples, I'd assign them to Erica. But since they're marine, I'm going to go ahead and assign them to Steve. Using this app, we ensure that high priority tasks are completed in a timely manner. On his phone, Steve sees the assignments pop up. Since Workforce is integrated with Collector, he can log the assignment and finish it. Our goal with Workforce is to coordinate with additional tribes and health departments to ensure that high priority areas remain in production.
Another task we're streamlining is the mapping of our farm beds. In the past, mapping our beds has been a time-consuming project. We wanted to use imagery, but we have a special requirement for imagery because we want to see what our farm looks like at low tide. Flying a drone and processing the data with Drone to Map finally lets us see our farm with useful imagery and allows us to see the bigger picture. We can even see our farmers installing the nursery tubes, which will protect our gooey duck from predators while they're young. When outlining bed layout prior to our use of Drone to Map, our farmers had to estimate tidal elevation. But now we can use the elevation contour lines created by Drone to Map. We now know that we can expand these beds along this contour line and still be within the optimal range for farming gooey duck. Laying out farm beds prior to our use of Drone to Map was a boots on the ground approach where our farmers paced lines through the mud. Drone imagery revolutionizes how we do it. Using a digital terrain model, it's easy to see the natural drainages in the beach. We can build our beds around these to avoid our seed from being washed away. Now that we've designed the beds in our office, we can take the data into the field to make our bed layout faster and more efficient. Many of our stakeholders don't have the opportunity to visit our farms in person. Using 3D, we can take them on a virtual beach tour to help them understand what it takes to go from tide to table. Taylor Shellfish is using GIS to revolutionize our business for generations to come. We're confident that we have the tools needed to adapt to challenges in our dynamic environment, no matter what or where we grow. Thank you.